Over fully booked passport appointments, the government rolls out a service called Passport on Wheels. The controversy over the Jerry Ortega case continues. Now a lawyer warns presidential spokesperson Harry Roque may face graft charges for speaking up on the murder case. And elaborate costumes and dancing on the streets. The religious festival Sinulog officially opens in Cebu. Good evening, I'm Mai Rodriguez. Thanks for joining us. Controversy hounds the Department of Foreign Affairs over its passport appointment system. But the government assures the public it is doing everything it can to fix the problem. In a press briefing, presidential spokesperson Harry Roque says among the government's plans are putting up more consular offices outside Metro Manila. They're also rolling out an electronic payment system and improving online appointments. There's also the so-called Passport on Wheels service starting January 28.
Of course, we understand the frustration of our kababayans and the government that through the Department of Foreign Affairs is exerting efforts now to improve passport application. No? Now, at yesterday's launch of the Philippine passports with 10-year validity, the Department of Foreign Affairs announced that it has made and is planning several improvements in its passport system.
The Foreign Affairs Department denies there's a syndicate conniving with its employees that sell passport appointments at exorbitant prices. Foreign Affairs Secretary Alan Peter Cayetano says they're not, quote, stupid to not know if a syndicate exists. There was a flood of complaints this week after the DFA's website showed bookings were full until March. Some claim travel agencies are selling schedules for as high as 7,000 pesos. Cayetano says this is impossible since the DFA has barred travel agencies from getting slots since September. Before things get out of hand, the government explains why applicants are having a hard time setting a passport appointment. Our senior correspondent Ruth Cabal tells us more.
May, not her real name, needed to renew her passport for a trip to visit her father in Singapore this year. Upon logging in at the DFA website, she saw all appointments at 27 DFA offices were fully booked until March. She put up an inquiry on Facebook and was surprised to receive more than 10 responses, mostly from travel agencies, offering appointment slots for passport renewal for a fee, ranging from 1,500 to 2,500 pesos on top of the regular passport processing fee.
Paano sila nakakakuha ng slot? Eh, sa online natin, wala nang slot ko. Siya yung talaga nagsabi niya sa akin na may kakilala kasi kami sa DFA. Sa loob ng DFA, sabi niya ganon. Sila yung kumukuha ng appointment slot. Tapos, nagbabayad sa kanila. Parang nabother ako. Sabi, oh, ano yun? Anong nangyayari ka ako sa DFA, sa loob ng DFA? So talagang parang may lagay system.
Since September, the Foreign Affairs Department already canceled appointment slots reserved for travel agencies. But a quick search on Facebook would show several travel agencies and other companies are still offering passport appointment reservations. Anna, a resident of Zamboanga City, initially thought this was a Facebook page accredited by the DFA. She was told she would have to pay 1,500 to 2,000 pesos to secure a slot for passport application. Her sister went as far as going to the DFA Zamboanga City office to confirm the appointment code given to them.
Tama naman talaga na legit sila kasi nung pumunta yung kapatid ko sa Zamboanga DFA, ni-verify niya doon, okay naman yung status niya. Meron talagang nangyari na inside job, kung ako mag-analyze, mas malaki pa yung kinita nila kaysa sa gobyerno. Kaya kami, sabi ko sa kapatid ko, kailangan malaman ito nila kasi paano na lang lahat ng tao lang.
Foreign Affairs Secretary Alan Peter Cayetano acknowledges there are challenges in the passport application and renewal processing, especially in securing an appointment online. But to accommodate applicants while making sure the website is secure, they only open slots every 3 months. The next opening of appointment schedules is in April. But due to the volume of demand, Cayetano says they are opening more slots for February and March.
Question, bakit 3 months wala na? We only open 3 months at a time kasi iniisa-isa namin kung tunay yung pangalan. Only 70% of those na naglalagay ng pangalan ang dumadating. Yung 30% for one reason or the other, whether legitimate, nagkasakit, hindi sila pwede, yung anak kailangan ni atin, or whether naglagay tapos trinatry nila ibenta ang kanilang slot, hindi dumadating.
The DFA stresses they have no Facebook page for passport processing assistance and that appointments can only be made on the website www.passport.gov.ph. Passport appointments are free of charge, while the processing of passports are from 900 to 1,200 pesos. Ruth Cabal, CNN Philippines.
We have this breaking news. We are getting reports that a column of ash is covering the slope of Mayon volcano. Netizens report hearing rumbling sounds and smelling sulfur in the area. Joining us now on the line, FEVOC's Director Renato Solidum. Good evening, Director. What do you know so far about this ash fall and the reports over there near Mount Mayon? And what does this signify, Director?
Mayon volcano had a phreatic or steam-driven eruption starting at 5:06 this afternoon. Still ongoing, but the summit is covered by clouds, but you can actually see a column of grayish-white cloud, essentially, that would be drifted to the southwest because of the strong winds. And that is why some areas in the Gaspe or Daraga have been posting in their Facebook asphalt being experienced.
Director, a phreatic steam-driven eruption, does this mean nag-raise na po ba ng alert level dyan sa Mayon volcano?
We have raised the alert level at Mayon volcano to alert level 1, signifying the abnormality of the volcano. And that is why we have been maintaining that people should not go to the top or summit or even inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone because of the possibility of steam-driven eruption. In technical description, it's called a phreatic eruption or steam-driven eruption.
Mm-hmm. Ano po ba ang contingency measures para sa ganitong klaseng eruption, Director?
Well, essentially, the main danger would be the asphalt. So people should cover their mouths and noses with wet clothes or handkerchief or even mask. And they need to close their windows and doors during the actual eruption with asphalt events. And after that, then they need to clean their surrounding, especially the roads. Those roads which are covered by ash can be slippery. So they need to hose down or sweep the ash away from the road. Mm-hmm. Essentially, at this time, though, we also need to emphasize that we have been reminding that airlines should not fly over the summit of the volcano.
Director Solidum, would you know for how long this steam-driven eruption will continue?
Of course not, but it's still ongoing as we speak, based on our seismic record. Essentially, the eruptions which are like this can be prolonged. It will not be very long. Maybe it will wane. But essentially, the condition would mean that people should exercise caution. And because of this, the ash would be the main danger as of now.
Mm-hmm. Ano pa po bang abnormal activities ang to be expected dyan sa Mayon volcano, Director?
Well, if it's just simply a an eruption recycling old ash, which is at the summit of the volcano, then we can expect steam-driven or phreatic eruptions, as we actually have mentioned in our daily evaluation of the volcano. We need to, of course, monitor the volcano in more detail if there will be other signals that it would tell us in case there will be magma coming from below.
All right, thank you for your time. Good evening, Director Solidum of the FEVOCs. When the newsroom returns, the family of a fallen Marine finally gets closure months after he went missing at the height of the Marawi crisis. And more Supreme Court justices are testifying against Chief Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno as her impeachment hearing resumes on Monday. Back after a quick break, keep it here on CNN Philippines. Facebook Live, thank you po for joining us this evening. Kakapasok lang po na balita yung ash fall dyan sa slope of Mayon Volcano, and netizens also reported hearing rumbling sounds and smelling sulfur in the area. We just talked to FIVOLC's Director Renato Solidum at sinabi nga niya they've just recorded a phreatic or steam-driven eruption, and they've raised alert level 1 over Mount Mayon. Ang contingency measures lang, no, dinaremind nila yung public na mag-wear ng masks, cover their mouths, noses, and of course to exercise caution. Just be careful of the ash fall kasi masama din po yan sa kanilang kalusugan. Also, we're monitoring the controversy sa DFA over the fully booked appointment schedule, fully booked until March, ano? So dinagsa ng mga reklamo ang Office of the Department of Foreign Affairs this week. At sabi nga ni DFA Secretary Alan Peter Cayetano, walang sindikato, but that's despite the reports coming in from netizens earlier na nagsasabi nga possible may collusion ng travel agencies with insiders dun sa DFA, ano? At binibenta nga yung mga slots for exorbitant fees. Patuloy nating imo-monitor yan. Stay tuned for more stories. We'll be back. The newsroom on CNN Philippines. Welcome back. One of the lawyers of former Palawan Governor Joel Reyes slams presidential spokesperson Harry Roque for criticizing the Court of Appeals decision clearing his client of murder. Attorney Ferdy Topacio says Roque may find himself facing a graft complaint if he continues to speak up on the issue. Anjo Alimario has more.
Let me begin. Mental dishonesty to the highest level. That's how Attorney Ferdinand Topacio describes presidential spokesperson Harry Roque's statement when he spoke about the murder case of environmentalist and broadcaster Dr. Jerry Ortega. Roque served as the lawyer of the Ortega family who filed a case against former Palawan Governor Joel Reyes. He questions the Court of Appeals decision that overturned a Palawan RTC's ruling that there is probable cause to try Reyes for Ortega's death and the order for his arrest. Roque pointed out the Supreme Court itself had already ruled in favor of the RTC. But Topacio says jurisdiction is not the issue.
Hindi po sinasabi doon sa desisyon na yon na yung finding ng probable cause ay tama o mali. Bakit? Because it was never an issue.
Topacio says on the matter of determining probable cause, the appeals court has the authority to interfere.
Secretary Roque, please save the mental dishonesty for when you go back to private practice. Don't us, wag po kami, and do not use the precedent for this, please.
He adds it's the prosecution that should be blamed for the dismissal of the case against his client, saying it failed to present adequate evidence. Topacio now wants Roque to choose stay as presidential spokesperson or continue practicing law.
That is unethical, and that may also subject him to complaint for graft, for using undue and improper pressure and influence upon other public officials.
Roque says Topacio is entitled to his opinion, but
I have said this over again and again, the president is the chief implementer of the law. It prosecutes cases in the name of the people of the Philippines and cannot sit idly by when there is an instance of a travesty of justice.
As the word war against Topacio and Roque heats up, the Ortega family is still longing for justice 7 years after his death. Anjoli Mario, CNN Philippines.
Three Supreme Court justices will face the House Committee on Justice on Monday as the impeachment hearing against Chief Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno resumes. Joyce Ilas tells us one lawmaker wants to check the motives of the justices.
Did Chief Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno violate the Constitution? Three Supreme Court justices will testify on this allegation as the impeachment hearing against Sereno resumes on Monday. House Justice Committee Chairman Ray Umali says Associate Justice Lucas Bersamin will be asked about resolutions Sereno supposedly issued without full court approval. Associate Justice Diosdado Peralta on Sereno's alleged manipulation of the Judicial and Bar Council and on court rules and procedures. And Associate Justice Samuel Martirez on the delay of retirement benefits of judges and justices.
These are important kasi again, this will substantiate yung mga aspect of transgression of the collegial nature of the Supreme Court, will help strengthen the position of the prosecution if they will reveal all of this and they would support whatever has been said.
Umali says his committee also invited Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, but begged off as he has no personal knowledge of the issue. His committee will study whether or not they will accept Carpio's refusal to attend the hearing. Meanwhile, impeachment complainant Larry Gadon expressed confidence the House of Representatives will impeach Sereno.
Naghahamon na nga ako ng pustahan eh. 100, tama, 1,000 eh. Right now, I can take the bet. The testimony of the justices themselves, di ba? Sobrang tibay. Maliwanag na maliwanag yung culpable violation of the Constitution.
For his part, ABS Partylist Representative Eugene De Vera says they should also assess the motive of some justices in testifying against Sereno.
Hindi ko naman tatanggalin din yung pag-iisip na baka masama lang ang loob o dahil na-bypass sila, kaya sila nag-appear ngayon, pwedeng to get back at the Chief Justice, gano'n.
Three Supreme Court justices and one retired justice testified against Sereno in the impeachment hearings last year. Sereno has repeatedly denied all of the allegations against her. Umali says the committee is hoping to finish the impeachment hearings by the end of February. Joyce Ilas, CNN Philippines.
More than 7 months since a young Marine went missing in Marawi, his remains have finally been identified. He becomes the last soldier to be accounted for in the military campaign against terrorists in Marawi. As our senior correspondent David Santos tells us, this brings much-needed closure not only to his family, but to other Marines as well.
Private Alejandro Balayan finally comes home. The 26-year-old Marine from Albay was only months in the service when he went missing in action in Marawi in June last year. He was with 13 men, including two junior officers, who were killed in a fierce gun battle with Maute fighters. Balayan reportedly fell off the Agus River at the height of the fighting. His remains were recovered 2 months later, in August, but it wasn't confirmed to be of Balayan's until DNA test results came out in December.
We want to make sure na siya talaga yun.
Balayan's distraught family now somehow relieved. They are finally laying him to rest while the Marines accord him honors fitting for a hero. The armed forces' death toll is now at 168.
The last hero of the Philippine Marine Corps, of the entire armed forces actually, na namatay, na ngayon lang namin nabigyan, which is, he is worthy to be given that ceremony as a hero.
In Marawi, authorities have yet to open the former battle zone to the public more than 3 months since the war ended. Around 30-40% of the main battle area has so far been cleared of explosives. Mayor Mahul Gandamra hopes the area can be secured completely by late March to early April. He says the extension of martial law can help security forces snuff out emerging security threats.
Natapos na po ang kaguluhan sa Marawi City, pero nandyan pa rin po ang mga pwedeng threat na maaaring mag-resurrect yung grupo na pumasok sa Marawi City. That's the reason why yung extension of martial law ay ating sinusuportahan.
Because we're not sure when the next Marawi incident might happen. So we have to be prepared for that, not only as an organization but as an individual soldier.
David Santos, CNN Philippines.
Still ahead, we find out how drivers are working double time to keep up with the jeepney modernization program. And Steven Seagal is next on the list of Hollywood actors facing allegations of sexual assault. This is Newsroom Weekend on CNN Philippines. Stay tuned. Hello again to our viewers on Facebook. Thank you for joining us this evening. I'd like to start with greetings because we just have 1 minute in this break. I'd like to say hello to my Auntie Lindy. She is watching me from New Jersey. Wow. She says, your number one fan watching from New Jersey, USA. I think this is the first time she's catching me on a live broadcast. Hello, how are you in the cold east? Sana you're staying warm. Also, hello to Hafiz Batugan from Cebu. Fer R. Lopez is saying hello. Si Mary Ann Seldura is sending her greetings also. And si Sammy Reintar from Rome. Alex Santos San Pedro from Qatar. Ayan, marami pong nanonood sa atin. Thank you all for your greetings. Stay tuned until the end of the show. Marami pa pong storya. The newsroom's back with more stories. With the government's PUV modernization program kicking off this month, drivers and operators are working double time so their jeepneys can stay on the road. But as Makoy Popioco reports, some drivers are having trouble keeping up with the changes.
This jeepney is a dream come true for Eddie Manguba. After over 20 years of driving other people's jeepneys, he finally had a chance to buy his own last year. But to keep it, he would need to pay 700 pesos every day for the next 2 years. The problem is, the jeepney is almost 2 decades old. That is why he fears he could get flagged down by authorities anytime, as the government vows to get rid of old jeepneys starting this month.
Natatakot kami mahuli dahil mahal din ang tubos niyan eh. Katulad yun, umupa ako ng bahay. Dahil nag-aarap pa yung aking isang anak. Pag hindi nakabiyahe, di gutom kami, pati baka palayasin kami sa bahay, walang bayad.
Manguba is slowly fixing his unit, starting with painting the headboard and repairing the ceiling. But he needs to do more repairs.
Hindi pa ako tapos. Inaayos ko yung sasakyan ko, pagkakadakuding. Kasi yung boundary niya, hindi pa napupunta sa akin.
The Jeepney Association, where Manguba is a member, is now strictly enforcing policies like wearing their uniforms on weekdays.
Hindi lang sinasabi ko sa mga member na pintahan para maging maayos yung dating ng jeep. Hindi katulad, makikita talaga bulok. Pag nadaan niya, talagang huli ka eh.
Almost all of their members have now repaired or installed seatbelts. Jeepney Association President Jose Rigor de la Cruz says smoke emission is also closely monitored. As for Manguba, he hopes the government buys him some more time.
Ay, dapat bigyan kami ng panahon na magkaroon ng kaunting kakayan na mapaganda yung jeep namin dahil kasi wala naman kaming kakayanan na bumili ng sarili namin.
Transportation Undersecretary for Roads Tim Orbos says they are pleased to know jeepney operators are cooperating.
Napansin ho namin yesterday na totoo yun, no? There were already some jeepneys, actually several, that were complying. Makikita mo bago yung gulong nila. And then we really appreciate it. And the government is really thankful that they're responding to our requirements. We're not after, let's say, the body appearance, but we're after items like the brakes, yung gulong, yung smoke emission. Yun po yung mga basic that we hope that they would really focus on. So rather than, let's say, make a general makeover of their vehicles.
Orbos says, even as they try to stay considerate, enforcers will continue apprehending violators. Makoy Popioco, CNN, Philippines.
Donald Trump isn't attending the opening of a new U.S. embassy in London, but that doesn't mean Londoners will miss the opportunity to take selfies with the American president. Madame Tussauds decided to put its wax version of Trump in front of the new embassy building. Museum officials say the decision was made spontaneously after Trump tweeted Thursday that he won't be at the ceremonial opening next month. Trump canceled the trip because, quote, the Obama administration sold the best located and finest embassy in London for peanuts, only to build a new one, unquote. However, the decision to move the embassy was made in 2008 by President George W. Bush and not Obama. The new location was selected more than a decade ago amid security concerns. A Disney favorite is finally getting a star on the Walk of Fame. It's Mickey's lifelong sweetheart, Minnie Mouse. Disney CEO Bob Iger and pop star Katy Perry will be there for the star unveiling on Monday, January 22nd. The Walk of Fame ceremony's producer says, quote, Minnie Mouse is a woman of the ages and her iconic status makes her a great addition to our Walk of Fame. Minnie is also being honored for 90 years in the motion picture business. She first appeared in Disney's Steamboat Willie. Actor Steven Seagal is under investigation for alleged sexual assault. The incident allegedly happened in 2005. A number of women have accused Seagal of sexual harassment or assault in recent months. They include actresses Jenny McCarthy, Juliana Margulies, and Portia de Rossi. They said Seagal used auditions for his movies to make inappropriate advances towards them. McCarthy claims Seagal tried to get her to take off her clothes when she auditioned for Under Siege 2 in 1995. She says her script did not call for any nude scenes. Seagal denied the accusation and he won't comment on the new investigation. One of the biggest festivals in the country, Sinulog 2018, officially started Friday with an opening salvo. Cebu-based schools participated in the launching parade, which started from the Basilica Minor del Santo Niño, passing through Osmeña Boulevard, and ended at the Cebu City Sports Center. The launch paves the way for the series of activities leading up to January 20th for the Sinulog Grand Parade. The annual celebration is in honor of Santo Niño, or the Child Jesus. Security is tight for the week-long celebration, with thousands of tourists expected to arrive. We're going back to our breaking news story. We're getting reports that a column of ash is covering the slope of Mayon volcano. Netizens report hearing rumbling sounds and smelling sulfur in the area. Speaking to FIVOC's Director Renato Solidum earlier, he said they've recorded a phreatic or steam-driven eruption at Mayon volcano and it is still ongoing, and that alert level 1 is raised over Mount Mayon. Residents near the volcano must exercise caution, and he said to wear masks and monitor the situation. That's what's happening in the newsroom this Saturday, January 13. I'm Mai Rodriguez. Stay with CNN Philippines, where we tell the story of the Filipino. Good night.